Hey, what's up YouTube? Jeremiah Hersey here from Pragmatic Works. And today we're gonna be talking about how to connect directly into OneDrive through Power BI. Now this was a request as I was in a hackathon. They were asking about how do I connect to OneDrive online so that way if it's updated in OneDrive, my Power BI file is updated as well. So there is no direct connector to OneDrive through Power BI. So we're gonna use a workaround using the web connector. So let's go ahead and take a look at our data and see what we're working with. So here we are inside of my OneDrive account. And the file that I'm gonna be looking at is the check-in details file right here. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna go into the file. So we can see that I have some basic information in here, some names, a purpose of visit. And what we're gonna do is we are going to try to connect through Power BI into this report. Now, your first idea might be to click the database icon and look for OneDrive, which once again, as I said before, there is no connector for OneDrive. The other thing that you might think of is because this is an Excel file that we could just connect into Power BI using the Excel connector. But once again, remember that this Excel workbook connector is for importing, okay? Bringing our data into the Power BI desktop inside the Power Query Editor. What we want to do is we want to do a direct connection into our OneDrive file. So in order to do that, we're going to be using the web connector. So we're going to be using the web connector here. So first things first is we need to get the file path. Okay, so we need to get the file path for that Excel worksheet. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go over to my OneDrive account. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna try to find the file path originally from inside of OneDrive. So if you click file and try to go to info, you're not gonna see a file path location or a way to copy out the file path. What you need to do is you need to open it in the desktop app. Okay, so you need to open this file in the desktop app. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on that. It's gonna log you in, and then you're gonna be brought inside of the desktop application. Same file, same information. But now when we go to file in the upper left-hand corner and go to info, notice that I have the option to copy the file path. And that's what we're gonna do. So we're gonna click copy the file path here. I'm gonna go back inside of Power BI Desktop and I'm gonna select my web connector. Now, when you paste this in, there's going to be a little piece at the end here. So you wanna make sure that you delete. So right here at the very end, okay, it's got the question mark web equals one. You want to make sure that you remove that all the way back until the .xlsx. And then we're going to click OK. This is going to bring us into our preview where we can then either load or transform our data. If I select table one, we can see that the information is inside of there. And I'll go ahead and load this. And I'll bring a table in just so we can verify the information that we're looking at here. So I'll go ahead and bring in the first name and maybe the purpose of visit. Make this a little bit bigger here. All right, so there is our three records. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go back over to where my desktop, where I have it open in the desktop, and I'm gonna add some files here. So I'm gonna add Matt Peterson needs a battery and maybe Jonathan Silva needs a charger. All right, so I've made some changes inside the desktop. I'm gonna go ahead and Control S to make sure that I save this. I'm gonna go back over to my desktop, and now when I click refresh inside of my report, you're gonna see the additional files right here for Jonathan and Matt. So now, as you can see, we have now connected directly into our OneDrive file. So as those changes are made in our OneDrive, it's gonna be updated inside of the Power BI desktop. Thank you so much for joining me. If you like the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel so that you get more content. I'll see you in the next one.